Hello everybody, today we are going to study about right circular cylinder. Okay, so first I have one model of right circular cylinder that I am showing you. Okay, this is example of right circular cylinder. Okay, so first we will see why it is called a right circular cylinder. Okay, if you will observe this, there are two circular ends, top and bottom, and this is known as curved surface area. Okay, this is curved surface area. Top and bottom are circular and both ends are identical. Identical means what? The area of base and area of top is same. Okay, means radius is same, radius of both the sides, both the top and bottom is same or are the same. Okay, so here we can consider this is the height of the cylinder. Okay, if I will take cylinder this way, this position, then here we can say this is the length of cylinder. Okay, so first we will see some parts of this. Everybody knows this is the circumference of the circle. Okay, and circumference of the circle we denote by 2 pi r. Okay, this is the center of the circle, and here also center of the circle. Okay, a line segment which is joining both the centers, center of top and center of bottom, is known as axis. Okay, this is radius, the distance between center to the circumference, that is known as radius of the circle. Okay, this is height, just now I told you. Okay, so now this is a right circular cylinder. Why it is right circular cylinder? Because this height is perpendicular to the base as well as top also. Means it makes 90 degree angle here. So this is a right circular cylinder. Okay, one more thing I have. This is also an example of cylinder, but this is not right circular cylinder because here top and bottom is not identical. So this is, we cannot say this is right circular cylinder, but this is a perfect example of right circular cylinder because height is perpendicular. Okay, so got everybody? Means here we can make a definition of cylinder that a solid, this is a solid, three-dimensional figure, a solid which is generated by revolving a rectangular sheet of its one side, revolving a rectangular sheet of its one side, that is known as cylinder, right circular cylinder. Okay, so now first we will think about curved surface area of the cylinder. Curved surface area means what? This is the curved surface area. In curved surface area, we don't have to think about top and bottom. Okay, we have to think only curved surface area. Okay, so now I'm going to show here one paper cylinder. Okay, see here, I have one cylinder which is open from both the sides, top and bottom. Okay, here thickness of this cylinder is negligible, means we cannot measure. Okay, negligible thickness. So this is a right circular cylinder. Okay, now we are going to think about curved surface area of this cylinder. Curved surface area means this area. Okay, so everybody knows this is circumference. Circumference we denote by 2 pi r. Okay, circumference we denote by 2 pi r, and height generally we take h. Okay, radius we have taken here r, and pi means 22/7, that value afterwards we will take. Okay, so this is a cylinder and we are going to measure its curved surface area. Okay, so suppose I will open this. Okay, it is joined here, I will open this, then what I will get here? Okay, when I will open this, then I will get a rectangular sheet. Okay, when it was in cylindrical shape, that time we have taken this distance is circumference, that is 2 pi r, and this was the height. But when now I have a rectangular sheet of the same cylinder. Okay, so this distance is going to be 2 pi r. Okay, so that now I am showing here, that is here, this is a rectangular sheet, okay, of the same cylinder. Now this distance is 2 pi r, this distance we have taken 2 pi r. Okay, and this distance is height of the cylinder, and this is the breadth of the rectangular sheet. Okay, suppose now I want to find out area of this rectangular sheet. So what I will do, I need to do length into breadth, length multiply by breadth. Okay, so area of rectangular sheet is equal to the curved surface area of the cylinder. Okay, so area of rectangular sheet is equal to length into breadth. Here length is 2 pi r into breadth is h. So finally you got 2 pi r h. Okay, so this is area of rectangular sheet means what? Area of curved surface area. Okay, so here we got curved surface area of the cylinder. Okay, so CSA, curved surface area of right circular cylinder is 2 pi r h. Okay, now we are going to think about total surface area of the cylinder. Okay, so total surface area in that, what we are going to think, total surface area in that, curved surface area is going to come as well as area of top and area of bottom, which are identical, that also we need to include. Okay, so curved surface area we have, that is I have taken here 2 pi r h. So total surface area is equals to, total surface area is equals to curved surface area 2 pi r h plus area of this circle. What will be the area of this circle? Pi r square. Okay, area of circle we use pi r square, as well as this area is also pi r square. So 2 times we need to add. So plus pi r square plus pi r square. Okay, so here we can do here addition, 2 pi r h plus pi r square plus pi r square will be 2 pi r square, because like terms, 2 pi r square. Okay, so now here we can take from both, there are two terms, from both the terms we can take 2 pi r common, 2 pi r we can take common. So what is going to remain? 2 pi r in bracket, what is going to remain from this h, and from this 1 r is going to remain. Okay, so this is known as total surface area of the cylinder. This is known as total surface area of the cylinder. We have seen two things. First one, curved surface area and total surface area. In total surface area, we need to add areas of top and bottom, which are identical, this and this. Okay, so area of curved surface area is 2 pi r h, and total surface area is 2 pi r, r plus h. Okay, this is total surface area. Now one more thing we are going to study, that is hollow cylinder. This is hollow cylinder. This is an example of hollow cylinder. Okay, what is the difference between a regular cylinder, right circular cylinder, regular cylinder and hollow cylinder? Okay, if you'll observe here, see, thickness is getting here. Okay, where here thickness was negligible, in this thickness was negligible, but here we can measure thickness. Okay, if you observe here, you will get, means definitely you will get there 2 radius. Okay, this is inner circle, its radius will be different, and this is outer circle, this radius will be different. Okay, so here also we need to find out curved surface area and total surface area. Okay, everybody got, there are 2 cylinders, you can see, this is inside inner circle and this is outer circle. Okay, so on this basis we are going to find out curved surface area and total surface area of the cylinder. Okay, so that I am writing here now, that is curved surface area of cylinder. Can you tell me what is the area of this base? Area of the base will be area of one side of hollow cylinder. Okay, generally we use pi r square, but here there are 2 radius. Okay, so here we can take pi r square minus r square, capital R square minus small r square. What is capital R? Capital R is equals to outer radius. And what is small r? Small r is equal to inner radius. Okay, so there is a difference between these two, capital R square minus small r square. Okay, so this is the area of one side, top or bottom we can say. Now we are going to think about curved surface area. Okay, there are 2 curved surface area. This is one curved surface area of outer circle, and inner circle also you will get. Okay, so curved surface area CSA of cylinder, CSA of hollow cylinder, CSA of hollow cylinder is equals to 2 pi r h, whose radius is capital R, 2 pi r h plus small cylinder in inner circle, that is 2 pi small r h. Okay, from this both we can take 2 pi, here also 2 pi is available, and h, height is same for both the cylinders, so that we can take common. So that will be 2 pi h in bracket, what is going to remain? This capital R plus small r, r plus h. Okay, so this is the curved surface area of hollow cylinder. This is hollow cylinder. Okay, this we have seen about ordinary cylinder. Okay, where thickness is negligible, but here thickness is measurable. That is the difference between these two. Okay, now we are going to think about total surface area, total surface area of the hollow cylinder. Okay, so TSA of hollow cylinder. TSA in that, what is going to come? this is going to come, these two are going to come, curved surface areas are going to come, plus this area and top area, top and bottom area. So I am taking this once again, that I am taking here 2 pi rh plus this 2 pi rh, or directly you can take this also, plus this area bottom plus pi r square minus r square. Two times we need to take top and bottom. So I am going to multiply here by 2. Okay. So now we will solve this, that is 2 pi rh plus 2 pi rh plus 2 pi, this a square minus b square property we need to use, that is r plus r and r minus r, a plus b, a minus b. Okay. So now here from this here 2 pi, here also 2 pi is available, so that we can take from these two, we can take 2 pi h common, 2 pi h, what is going to remain, r plus small r plus this 2 pi r plus r, r minus r. Okay, so there are two terms, this is one term and this is second term. Okay, from this we can take common 2 pi and r plus r. Okay, so that I am taking now 2 pi r plus small r, capital R plus small r, what is going to remain in bracket, from this what is going to remain in bracket, h plus this r minus r, r minus r. Okay, so this is the total surface area of hollow cylinder. Okay, so we have seen three things, that is first one, curved surface area of right circular cylinder, that is 2 pi r h. Then we have seen total surface area of cylinder, that is 2 pi r, r plus h. Then we have seen hollow cylinder, that is curved surface area of hollow cylinder is equals to 2 pi h in bracket r plus h. And second one, we have seen total surface area of hollow cylinder is 2 pi in bracket r plus r into h plus r minus r. Okay, so now we are going to see some examples depend on this. Okay, so now our first example is, our first example is given here, that is, see, very simple example, the curved surface area, the curved surface area of a right circular cylinder of height 14 cm is 88 cm square, is 88 cm square. Means what is given, see here, 14 cm, what is 14 cm height, height of the cylinder. So h is equal to 14 cm. Okay. Then what is given, 88 cm, what is it, curved surface area. So curved surface area is equals to 88 cm square. And we have to find out diameter. Diameter, to find out diameter, we need to do, we need to find out radius first. Okay. So we can use here 2 pi r h is equal to 88 cm square. From that 2 multiply by value of pi, we can take 22 by 7 multiply by radius is, that we have to find out. So radius will come r into h is 14 cm is equal to 88. Okay, so 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14. Okay, 22 twos are 44 and 44 twos are 88. 88 into r is equal to 88. So r equals to what? 88 divided by 88. 88 divided by 88. So r equals to 1 centimeter. Okay, so this is the radius and they are asking us diameter, find the diameter of the base. Okay, so diameter is equals to, diameter is equals to 2 times radius. So 2 multiply by 1 centimeter, that is 2 centimeter. Okay, so this was very simple example, depend on the first thing, curved surface area of the cylinder. Okay, now we will see second example. Okay, so second example is the ratio between the curved surface area and the total surface area of a right circular cylinder is 1:2. Okay, so we have seen curved surface area, CSA of cylinder is equals to 2 pi rh, curved surface area of cylinder is 2 pi rh, and total surface area, total surface area of cylinder is equals to, here just now we have seen total surface area 2 pi r, r plus h. So here 2 pi r R plus H. Okay. So what is given according to the question? The ratio between the curved surface area and total surface area of cylinder. Curved surface area CAC upon TAC of cylinder is given 1:2. Okay, is given 1:2, means 1/2 we can write. Okay, so curved surface area, what is that? 2 pi r h divided by 2 pi r in bracket r plus h is equal to 1/2. Okay, and they are asking find the ratio between the height and radius of the cylinder. We have to find out ratio of height and radius of the cylinder. Okay, here 2 pi r h and here 2 pi r. Okay, so 2 pi r and this 2 pi r we can cancel because division is there, so we can cancel it. So what is remaining here? H upon r plus h is equal to 1/2. Now we can cross multiply it. Okay, so that I am doing here now, we can cross multiply, that will come 2 into h is equal to 1 into r plus h is equal to r plus h. 1 multiplied by r plus h is r plus h. Okay, so 2h plus h will come here, minus h is equal to r. So 2h minus h is h is equal to r. So we have to find out ratio. So what will come here? H upon r is equal to, what is going to remain here? 1/1. So ratio is h is to r is 1:1. So that is the answer. Okay, thank you. Our next problem is, Savitri had to make a model of cylindrical kaleidoscope for her science project. She wanted to use chart paper to make the curved surface of the kaleidoscope. What should be the area of the chart paper required by her if she wanted to make a kaleidoscope of length 25 cm with a 3.5 cm radius? Okay, kaleidoscope. And what is given? Chart paper, okay? Chart paper for kaleidoscope. And make the curved surface area. Here directly it is given, curved surface area. Okay, so we have to use there 2 pi r h, obviously, okay? So here what is, which things are given? 25 cm. Length is 25 cm. So length in terms of height we have to consider. So here we have to take what is given things. Given height is equal to 25 cm. And what is given? 3.5 cm radius. So r equals to 3.5 cm. Okay. So chart paper is equals to what? Chart paper is equals to curved surface area. Okay. So here CSA of kaleidoscope, that is cylinder, is equals to 2 pi r h. Very simple example. Is equal to 2 multiplied by pi is 22 by 7. The radius they have given us directly, so 3.5 multiplied by h is also given 25 cm. Okay, so the product, this is area, so definitely it will come centimeter square. Okay, so now here we can take here 7 5 star means 0.5. okay, so 25 into 2 50 multiplied by 22 5 star, 110. Decimal point is there, so it will come 11 centimeter square. So here 550 centimeter square. Okay, so that much chart paper is required. Okay, so this is your answer. So this is depend on only one concept. Okay, so now next problem we will see, that is an iron pipe 20 centimeter long. Iron pipe, okay, here you will come to know, iron pipe means here we have to think about hollow cylinder. Okay, an iron pipe 20 centimeter long has exterior diameter, just now I told you, exterior diameter, okay, like that cylinder, exterior diameter means from this to this distance, and interior means from this to this, okay, exterior diameter 20 centimeter, iron pipe 20 centimeter long means height is 20 centimeter, height is given 20 centimeter, okay, has exterior diameter is equals to 25 centimeter, okay, exterior diameter. So exterior radius, how we use, which letter we use? Capital R, okay, so R, that is exterior radius is equals to 25 by 2, that is 12.5 centimeter. Okay. Now, what they have given us, if the thickness of the pipe means this distance is given 1 centimeter, thickness of the pipe 1 centimeter. So, with the help of this, we have to find out inner radius. Okay. So, what will be the inner diameter? Inner diameter is equal to 25 centimeter. This is outer. Inner means we have to subtract 1 from this side, 1 from this side. So, minus 1 plus 1. So, 25 minus 1 plus 1 is 2. 25 minus 2 is equal to 23. This is 23 centimeter is the inner diameter. So, inner radius is equal to what? Inner radius is equal to 23 by 2. So, 11.5 centimeter. So, both the radius we have. Now, they have us directly find the whole surface of the pipe. Whole surface means total surface area of the pipe we have to find out. Means total surface area of hollow cylinder, that formula we need to use here. Okay. So, TSA of hollow cylinder. Okay. Hollow cylinder. What is the formula of TSA of hollow cylinder? Is equals to, that is 2 pi. What is the formula? Just now we have seen 2 pi in bracket r plus capital R plus small r, another bracket, what is going to come? H plus capital R minus small r. Okay. So, now just we have to put up the values, is equal to 2 multiplied by 22 by 7, value of pi in bracket r is 12.5 plus 11.5. Another bracket, height is 20 centimeter they have given us. So, 20 plus 12.5 minus 11.5. Okay. So, now 22 twos are 44, 44 by 7. Okay. Multiply by sum of 12.5 plus 11.5 will be 12 plus 11 is 23 and 0.5 plus 0.5 1. So, 24 into this difference will be 1, 12.5 minus 1, 11.5 will be 1, 20 plus 1, 21. So, that I am taking here 21. Okay. So, this is also, it will come centimeter square. Okay. So, now 7 ones are 7, 7 threes are 21. Okay. So, now we will find out product of this 44 into 3, 4 threes are 12, 2 1 carry, 4 threes are 12 plus 1, 13, 132 multiply by 24 centimeter square. Okay, 24 twos are 24 into 2, 48, 8 4 carry, 24 threes are 72 plus 4, 76, 6 7 carry, 24 ones are 24 plus 7, 31, 3168 centimeter square. Okay, so this was about hollow cylinder. So, in hollow cylinder, we need to think about two radius, inner radius and outer radius. Without that, we cannot solve. Okay. So, when such type of examples are coming, iron pipe, rubber tube, that time we need to use all the things of hollow cylinder. Okay. So, directly this formula we have to use. Sometimes we need to use curved surface area of ordinary cylinder and hollow cylinder together. Means when it is coming on two or three concepts, that time we have to use all the formulas together. Okay. Thank you.